And we're on.
So hello everybody. Welcome to Glam Beauty Life. I am Danielle.
Hey guys.
I'm Vivian. And we have Vivian here with us today.
I'm just turning on our iPad so we can record.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so we're going to record on the iPad too.
Yeah, so this is episode 2 of Glam Beauty Life.
Hey, welcome back guys.
Welcome back. To have you all with us today. Hopefully you all are staying warm if you're in the DMV area.
And also other places, because my friends in Florida and Texas.
Oh, yeah, it's like a cold.
It's cold everywhere.
It's like a cold snap in the East Coast.
In Kentucky,
area.
Yeah, I know. My KY girl. Yeah, no,
Midwest
it's been
too,
cold.
So,
yeah, definitely.
Yeah, you guys, drink lots of tea, you know, snuggle up, get warm.
All right, so just to introduce ourselves again, I'm Vivian Winter. Nice to meet you. I'm an esthetician and makeup artist, mentor to all. I've been in the beauty industry for 13 years. I've worked for a lot of the top luxury cosmetic brands, skin and makeup as well. And Danielle is like my girl, so we hooked up to do this show. So this is Danielle.
I am Danielle of Danielle D Beauty, freelance makeup artist, makeup artistry teacher. I'm actually starting next week with my new classes. I've been in the beauty industry for about 11 years now, and I've worked with almost all the photographers in the area, different cosmetic companies. So I'm really excited to be here with my girl Vivian. So we bring to you Glam Beauty Life. So let's get to it.
All right, cool. So let's see. Let's talk about our try and deny it.
Okay, so try and deny is a segment where we say, hey, you gotta try this, and then I'll deny it. So, hey,
we've tried it.
We've tried it. We've saved your time and money.
Don't do it.
Exactly.
So here's our try and deny it. So my try and deny it, number one, I love Hourglass. They're an anti-aging based cosmetic company. They're a vegan line. So they're one of the only luxury brands that's vegan. Also, they're the only one that has anti-aging in it. So I love their dim powder. I know a lot of people have talked about the ambient powders. The dim light is really good if you're light to medium tone as a finishing powder. And then they also have the bronzers. The deeper bronzer is great for dark to deep tones. And that is a highlight for us. Beautiful and popping.
You have to try it on me one day.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay, definitely. I'll do that. Then we'll do that. All right, so another one that I like too, since we're talking about highlighters.
Yes.
Have you tried the Laura Mercier Shimmer Bricks before?
So
okay, I love them.
I love their Shimmer Bricks. Okay, I used to be a Bobbi Brown Shimmer Brick, which I still love. But once I discovered the Laura Mercier ones, oh my gosh, I used to work at a counter that was like adjacent to the Laura Mercier counter, and I used to always be over there like trying out their stuff. Their Shimmer Bricks are top notch. Love them.
Love them. And actually, all of those skin tones that they're made for, I believe they have 4 different ones.
They do.
So you can pick one for your skin tone. They're amazing. But for dark to deep women, it's beautiful. You know, anyone that's ever met me knows that I'll scream to the top of the heavens a blush and highlight for a deep woman.
Yes.
A deep woman. And a lot of the companies don't make them deep enough, don't have enough peach or brown in them. But the ones that I talk about specifically are ones that I know are amazing on brown skin, deep skin, and ones that we've used before. So with that being said, do you have any ones that you'd like to add, or I can add my last highlight? Later. I have another one.
No, you can go ahead.
Okay. So I was actually doing an event the other day on Saturday in store in Ulta Rockville. And I got a chance to try the Too Faced Peach Highlighters. Now it's a part of their peach collection. I'm not a huge there's a lot of new cosmetic brands, and so I'm just trying to be privy to them. But I do know some of them why some of them are really great. Well, this peach highlighter, women, if you're a woman of color, you have to get this peach highlighter. It smells like peaches, of course, as does everything else in the whole line.
Okay.
But it has a really deeper gold and deeper peach base, which is again perfect for deep skin. Anyone from myself, Danielle, and deeper and lighter. Beautiful.
So number 4 on our list is the L'Oreal True Match Foundation.
Yes.
Okay, so I discovered these almost when I first started doing makeup, and I used to have them in my kit. Now they have colors for deeper skin tones, which is like amazing. Those foundations are like so bomb. I think I used N8.
I'm in seven.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
I love the True Match foundations. Like, literally, I know she laughs at me. People laugh at me. I was just telling someone the other day, I actually have it on today, you guys. This True Match foundation is everything. So it's a sheer to medium finish. You can do full coverage with it, but it's mostly going to be a sheer to medium finish. They have, like she said, every color tone. So the thing I like about True Match is that they have your warms, they have your cools, and they have your neutrals, which is the N. That's what we talked about. N7, 7 being lighter, N8 light being 8 being deeper, and then lighter and deeper from that point on.
Yes.
So, and they will also have your warms and your cools. So, and we'll talk about that a little bit later, but this is amazing. Like, the foundation is awesome. You guys have to try it. It sets itself. You don't have to have a powder. Dry, oily, the combination skin. Anyone can use it. It's amazing. They're beautiful. I've hooked everyone on in my life. And actually, I've had clients that have asked, have I tried it? And of course, I tell them I have.
Yeah.
And if I happen to have it with me, which I do a lot of times in my personal bag, I'll let them try it on if they're my complexion and they love it. And they end up buying it. So, for what it's worth, it's amazing. My other tip, I've got another tip, the Witch Hazel. So has anyone ever used Witch Hazel before? I love Witch Hazel. Witch Hazel can be used on the skin. Witch Hazel is good for oily and dry skin. It's a light toner. So back in the day, we used to use toners that had a lot of alcohol. Mm-hmm. But now you don't need that. Most things are pH balanced on its own. Sea Breeze, Noxzema. Most things are pH balanced on their own. So I find that just keeping the skin regulated will do more for you in the long run.
Yeah.
Than it will we try to kind of try a bunch of things and it doesn't work for us. So Witch Hazel is wonderful. You can use it right after you wash your face. You can use it men after you have a haircut on your beard.
Yeah.
God, Witch Hazel is amazing for everything. Witch Hazel can be used to clean your ears. I mean, I don't even know. Like, I love Witch Hazel. It's awesome.
Yeah, me too. Anytime I run out of my toner, if I can't get to the store right away, I'll definitely use Witch Hazel. Always keep it in my arsenal to make sure I have it.
Oh, I love Witch Hazel. Yeah. Another thing you do too, especially if you travel a lot because your skin may get dehydrated, just put go in anywhere. Dollar store, Target, home goods, whatever. Get you a small spray bottle. Put your Witch Hazel in there and just kind of give yourself a refresher after you've traveled. It really does pick the skin up. It picks you up. It makes you feel more refreshed, and that cool water can feel really good when it's hot outside.
Absolutely.
So it's perfect. Alrighty, so let's you're denying. I hate the deniers. I've tried a lot, and let's just put it out there. So who do you have? I'll let you go first, because I'm going to go on a rant.
I'll let you go.
Okay, because you're brewing it too. Got
I'm
you.
Brewing it.
Okay, so mine, I love it, you guys. Now, I've worked in the retail stores for 13 years now, in every store here in the DMV for sure. And so I will tell you time and time again, any store that I work in that has this line, it has a cult following, guys.
It does.
It's Bare Minerals. I cannot do the mineral powders.
Oops.
When they are literally, the mineral powders will be the color of this white. But you're trying to match up someone who's deeper skin. So someone who's deeper skin to come in, and on the swatch on the front, it will show maybe your tone. It looks like, oh, that looks like me. You got to swatch it, and the powders are so light. They cast such a shadow when you're doing pictures, when you're just walking in real life and people just see you.
In real life.
And, you know, again, the deeper we go, and sometimes the undertones are off, so I've definitely tried it. I've been around them long time enough to know. But guys, if you're using that foundation, I mean, there's so many other powder foundations we can recommend. And please let us know, comment below, if that's something that you want us to talk about, because I know I can recommend a couple.
Yeah.
Actually, that True Match, the True Match powder is really good, too.
The blushes, too.
So even if you just want to start there, that's perfect too. So I'm gonna leave it alone. I'm not gonna do a rant, but just know to the Bare Mineral Powder Foundation.
Yes. So since we're on the subject of just beauty, let's get into the Golden Globes.
Mm-hmm. Let's do it.
Let me tell you something.
Okay. Cause were you here for them?
I was here for them.
Okay, me
even
too.
Even the dresses, I watched a couple shows and they were like, oh, Slayer, Nail, whatever. I thought that everyone represented their personal styles perfectly. Janelle Monáe and Giorgio Armani.
Yeah.
She was regal. She was like a little tutu doll. She was like a Barbie doll.
Beautiful.
She was beautiful.
And she has such a beautiful face with very small, delicate features as well.
She had a smoky eye and a nude, shimmery, shiny lip. Perfect.
Yes, gorgeous.
It was a tutu high-low dress. I don't know if you guys have seen it yet, but if you have, Google it.
Check it out.
See it.
Yeah,
she
definitely.
Was beautiful. Yeah. Who do you have?
So I have, let's see who I have. So I have Viola Davis, of course. She was beautiful in that yellow. It was gorgeous. It was radiant on her skin tone. Ladies, if you have deeper skin, please don't be afraid to wear colors in your makeup, your hair, your dress, your nail polish, your accessories, your handbag, your scarf, anything around that beautiful deep skin is gorgeous, ladies.
That yellow
is beautiful. Oh my gosh, she could have done red.
Her
she could have done anything bright, but that yellow.
That yellow was
gorgeous.
It just popped
out
of her skin.
Yeah.
Her makeup was really. She usually does a smoky eye. I just saw her on a show last week where she always has a smoky eye, but she had more of a fresh face look this time, and I thought it was a stellar look for her for this year.
Yeah, and then my other one, I had to shout out Issa Rae.
Did you guys see Issa Rae?
So even though she didn't take home any awards, just the fact that she was nominated in the building is so amazing. Shout out to Issa Rae. She's
shout
amazing, girl. We love you.
Yes.
We are supporting you, DMV,
absolutely.
Everybody.
Absolutely.
We love you.
So she was beautiful in
she
her
was gorgeous.
Custom-made Kristen Siriano dress.
Yes.
Who was her makeup artist?
Her makeup artist is Joanna Simkin.
Oh,
so
shout
let's
out
talk
to
about
her.
The dress, though. It went from the top of the neck down to the floor.
Right.
So it had a beautiful trumpet cut, and it was made of very beautiful, fine, stretchy fabric.
Yes.
And as we know, she has a beautiful body. She's tall. She's very muscular, but she's very tall and lean. And she looks amazing. And so that dress from the top down was just so classy and
beautiful.
Regal. And it was just gorgeous. It was everything that I needed.
It really was.
And also for her makeup, they were really cute. Her makeup, they gave her a brown smoky eye.
Yeah.
They gave her a bold brow and a bold lip.
Yeah.
Perfect. Her skin is beautiful. I think she's from Sierra Leone. She's beautiful.
Yes.
Yeah.
I have to, before we go into the next, I have to shout out my girl, Tracee Ellis Ross, for winning Best Actress in the comedy series. Oh my gosh.
You know I love Blackish. Splash is like my favorite show.
She gave me all kinds of life in her custom made Zuhair Mourad dress.
Yes, it was beautiful.
Her makeup artist was, I think it was Jamie Greenberg. It was very simple. Usually she does her own makeup, but I think that they did a great job in mimicking what she usually does. I don't think she really likes to go too much outside the box.
Yeah. I always see her with like a liner and a bold lip.
And a red lip. She definitely is a Ruby Woo girl. Yeah. So I thought that
or I think she what's the other one that's Danger? The one that looks like red and orange mixed together. That was
She was beautiful, beautiful. Congratulations to her for being the first, well, not first, but I think Debbie Allen was the last one to win that award in like 1988. So shout out to Tracy Ellis.
And also, I want to shout out Octavia Spencer too. She won the Best Supporting Actress in the motion picture Hidden Figures.
Yeah.
So she was amazing. Yeah, she's so, I love her. She's so beautiful. She's so cute. She's just amazing. Like, and that show is so powerful. The movie's so powerful, you guys. You have to go see it. Yeah.
And she had kind of a bad rap because she just wore a navy blue suit, but honey, she had on a 40 karat emerald ring from Lorraine Schwartz,
like, and it wasn't a bad suit. Actually, the blazer looked beautiful. It was just ill cut in the legs, but it was gorgeous.
It
the
was
suit
a gorgeous cut. I love
the beautiful
look
on her too. Yeah,
absolutely.
So that's okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so you have something you want to talk about, and your girl, you got this.
Okay, so let's have a, can we have a little bit of girl talk, please? Can we have a little, like, come close? Can we have a little bit of girl talk? Let me tell you guys something. Okay, so I'm newly single. Okay. It's okay. You know, everything's all good.
Nothing wrong
but
with it.
But let me tell you guys, I am not ready to date in 2017. I'm not. I give up.
Yeah.
I give up.
Okay.
So I gave my number to this guy this week, right? He was cute. You know, it was a good conversation. You guys, my number, my Facebook, I can't even talk. My Facebook picture, my Facebook name popped up in his phone. How?
Now, she was freaked out when she told me this.
Sweat.
I wasn't that freaked out because I didn't think it was that big of a deal. I know it's 2017. These things happen and people have their email connected to Google, which is connected to Facebook, which is... So, I know that it's fine. I wouldn't get freaked out. But I'll let her finish before I tell my side of it. But go ahead and let her finish.
So, he texted me yesterday and I'm like... I mean, I text him back or whatever, but I'm still kind of freaked out. Like, I don't think it's anything that he did on his end, but I just think this new, like, I'm an old school girl, right? I'm a 70s baby, and I'm used to, like, you know, the phone calls, and, you know, that's it. Like, I'm not used to the text messages in a new relationship. Like,
and granted, I don't, I was raised old school, too. Like, my parents are older. Like, I get that, you're right. I don't like the way it's being done. I'm getting
Yes, I gotta get used to this. And my cousin was like, welcome to dating in 2017. I was like, whatever, I'm over it. I just don't know how to move forward. I don't know if I want to meet anybody else. Like, God, just...
So just skip because we have to finish. She has to get to what really happened. So anyway, she ended up meeting this guy. She gave him their number. He called the next day. After she gave him the number, she was freaked out because she saw the contact. He called the next morning and she had the nerve to get mad at him because of the contact showing up. Okay, first of all, here's my thing. How could he have even predicted her name? Fine, okay. So say he had seen her before, but how would he know that her name is Danielle D. Beauty? Like, you have to pick the most random infinity that doesn't exist, okay?
Okay, okay.
So she's mad at him. He wanted to take her to breakfast. Don't y'all think she should have given him a chance? I say give him a chance. She doesn't have to get out there and date, but Danielle she's open to it. Don't let her sit there and do that. But you can't be if you keep closing people off and it has nothing to do with him.
Okay, I just have to get out of my mind that I'm freaked out about this. Like, I was already, like, shut down all my accounts. I was like, listen, I'm shutting down Facebook, I'm shutting down Instagram, but I can't because this is what I do.
Beauty.
But yo, like, you guys, comment below, like, how do y'all do this? How do you know, you guys that are single, how do y'all navigate this new dating thing, you know, with the Tinder and the match? I am on Tinder, but
no, there's nothing wrong with
it. But you know what I mean? Like, how do y'all do this? Like, I met
Dominique on Facebook. I know everybody knows that.
For me, I think Facebook is different because did you guys have mutual friends?
Yeah, of course. I mean, I have 5,000 friends on Facebook, so like, if I don't even, it's like, if I don't, I got mutual friends with your grandma. Okay? Me and your grandma have mutual friends.
Shout out to grandma.
Okay, like, honey.
But no, I think it's different if it's Facebook, because at least Facebook, you guys have some type of 6 degrees of separation.
Yeah,
right?
That's real. But we weren't, it was kind of like, you know how you message people, it was one of those situations. So I don't know if we were on it to date, but I'm all for Tinder. If I was single, I'd be on there.
Yes.
I just also think you have to let it come to you, and the only way it will come to you is if you open yourself up to it.
I agree. Okay, I'm trying. This is the first guy that I've kind of... you know, throw his hands or whatever. But you know,
she likes we'll see. She's gonna go. So we're gonna be back next week and let you guys know the update of them, because she is gonna go to breakfast with him. I will ensure that, and I'll let you guys know. Comment below if you think she should or should not, though, because actually I can't really control it, so she'll probably not go. So comment below if you guys think she should go. Comment below if you think she should not go.
And comment below to let me know, like, what in the world? Like, have y'all experienced this? And am I the only one? Like, I feel like I'm the only one this happened to. Like, I feel like that.
Okay, guys, we gotta go. In the meantime, we'll see you guys next week. So remember, if you have any makeup or facial requests, you can email or Instagram, Facebook, Google, plus everything at Vivian Winter. Also, you can do at Glam Beauty Life for any of your questions.
Yes.
Any of your concerns, you guys have any questions you want us to talk about on the show, beauty lifestyle, if you have any advice questions, if you guys have any anything that you want to tell us, a recipe you want to share with us, anything.
So just email us at glambeautylife@gmail.com.
And then Danielle, how do they contact you for what?
Well, they can contact me for, oh gosh, everything. But I am on Instagram, Facebook, on all social medias as Danielle D Beauty. So yeah, so just
and it's
add
D-E-N.
I was telling people that. D-E-N-Y-E-L-L-E.
And B-I-V-I-A-N Winter with a Y-W-Y-N-T-E-R. So we'll see you guys next week.
Thank you for tuning in, you guys.
Thank
this
you
is
for
fun.
Tuning
this is
in.
A fun
yeah,
show,
we
guys.
Love you guys.
We'll
already.
See you next time.
All right, talk to you soon.
Bye. Keep it going. Keep it going. Keep it going.